Hello and welcome, dear investor in the current market, so stock turmoil. My name is Thorsten, I'm the founder of Dividend Stocks Cash, and we are talking in this video about Carnival, disaster or turnaround. So the stock market crash is still ongoing, and turnaround could be or is a typical turnaround stock. In one of my latest video, I gave you an idea about different type of stocks you could invest, trying to benefit from the fallen stock prices. Carnival has a high risk, high risk reward profile, and we try to evaluate the current risk situation of Carnival. So let's go. Carnival shines, at least on paper, with a 20% dividend yield right now, and might be attractive for many dividend investors. I think what most people can't really judge is the risk they buy into their portfolio if they buy the stock. And we are now evaluating the risk together. I show you how you can proceed to get a much better idea about the risk. Okay, so let's go. And the risk is default risk, so it's the question, the primordial question is, does Carnival survive the Corona crisis? And we need to get an idea about the financial situation of the company, about the debt situation, and about the financial stress the company faces. Okay, so here we see some important balance positions. And what's interesting for us now is the debt. Here's the total debt and the cash on the other side. The company has to pay back the debt. And you see that latest numbers tell us that total debt is 90.7 billion high, and there is cash and cash equivalents of $580 million. And you already see that the cash is not as much as the total debt. That's already a bad sign, but how bad it is to determine this, we need to know how much of this total debt must be paid back within a short period, how much of these debts are current liabilities. To do so, we visit the latest annual report, which is still the latest report we have, and then we go to the balance sheet, and in the balance sheet, go back to the screen. How here you will see $90.7 billion US dollar total debt, and the 19.7 billion are these 9 billion plus this 9 billion. So it's the current liabilities, short-term debt, and long-term debt aggregated. So we see nearly half of the total debt needs to be is short-term. And we have only here 580 million cash and cash equivalents to pay back the short-term debt. We also have some receivables, which is good. We have inventories, but many ships are on hold right now. We have here some news, some bad news, and here, for example, we have brands which with a temporary pause in fleet cruise operations, so they are probably in harbors and they don't earn money. For example, Carnival Cruise Line completely. And we have here the market share. You probably know that Carnival is the market leader of cruise lines, responsible for about half of all passengers transported on cruises. And this is the Carnival Cruise Line, responsible for more than a fifth of all passenger transports. And they are completely on hold, and other lines are also. And other lines like AIDA, for example, are mostly on hold already. So it's a very bad situation for the company where we are here. And this means that the inventories, don't know what it is, towels or bottles of champagne and so on, they won't be sold because they will be sold on the ships, but the ships are not operational right now. So inventories won't help to pay back debts mostly. So very it shouldn't be, or if you see that 9 billion can't be paid back with 580 or let's say 1 billion of the current assets. If you, that's bad news, but if you look at 2018 or even in 2019, the situation already looked bad, but when things were much brighter than today, that was before the corona crisis appeared, and we had already such a financial imbalance between current assets and current liabilities. We also even had this in 2018. Now you might ask yourself, how did this company survive so long if they have so much short-term debt and only so less current assets to cover all this short-term debt? The answer is here in the customer deposits. If you are going to book a trip on a cruise line, then you will have to pay part of the price in advance. And this is customer deposits, and they are liabilities in the balance sheet, but the company mostly doesn't have to pay back these deposits, only if you cancel the trip. But normally that's no financial strain here, but now it's a financial strain, because most customers, or many customers, will have to cancel the trip even if they don't want, because the fleets are on hold. You see it here. So the Carnival has to pay back now a lot of these billions, or most part, I guess, of these 4.7 billions. It's from November 2019, so it's not completely actual, but I can think we can work with these numbers. They are the most current numbers we have. So, and this is additional financial stress to the company. In short, if you just look at this, and the company won't get new loans, it's bankrupt. The company is a complete default. Carnival, of course, the management knows that, and because of this, they gave us an update on debt funding and other matters. They have a revolving credit arrangement already in place, and it's about $3 billion, and they completely took these credits to ensure to their financial situation, or that they are not going bankrupt, at least in the short term. I don't think that this will be help for a very long time, because firstly, they have to pay back a lot of money. We've just seen that. On the other hand, revenues, we have here the P&L, profit and loss calculation, and you see revenues and operating costs. Revenues will go down dramatically, of course, but the operating costs and expenses, they will also go down, but I guess not as much as the revenues. Here you have the different types of costs. Some costs like fuel will go, will be close to zero if the ship is not shipping anymore, traveling across the sea. But payroll, for example, and related, depends on the contracts and country and so on, but payroll will have to continue, I guess. Our ship operating, maintenance and so on will have to continue. And I think that about, it's just a rough estimate, but we need to get an idea that about 40% or about 60% of all costs might be eliminated when the ships are on hold, but at least 40% need to continue. Which means if we have a total of nearly 30 billion operating expenses, it will be about, I already calculated this yesterday, about $400 million each month operating expenses, even if the complete fleet is on hold. And revenues will decline much more, which means that they'll always have to finance some $100 million each month. Additionally, there will also be other costs, which are investments. If we go here, that's a cash flow statement. Here we have investing activities, and here you see the purchase of property and equipment, which is mostly, you guess right, ships. And you see that the investments increase, so the Future looked bright for the company, obviously, because they increased investments from 3 billion to 3.8 billion to 5.4 billion. And they will have to finance these ships or all these investments. It's already investments they made because, but we see here a clear tendency of increase. So I think that they will, that this trend ordering new ships or upgrading existing ships still continues, which means that they will have to pay these increases and the extension of their fleet. I don't watch today. I did not took a look about the open orders, but that's just a plausible guess if you look at this tendency of increasing investments here. You will also have to pay this. You have to finance the operating activities and of course the investing activities. And with financing will be responsible, or the most important part will be to delay paying back debt and to get new debt. Because without this new debt, the company will go bankrupt, as I already told you. So basically, an investment in Carnival is not really an investment, but a speculation about first that the company receives all the money they need from either source, banks, or maybe government help, and secondly, that the corona crisis won't last too long, because if it lasts half a year or even longer, then the financial situation will deteriorate more and more, because the balance sheet will have this red column indicating the total debt will increasing. Maybe there will be also an how do we call it, a capital increase here. So the company might be forced to issue new stocks, and this will also dilute here the per earnings matrix, earnings per share, and so on. We see here still dividends, but I don't think that it's very realistic that they will pay dividend, continue to pay dividends for 2020 especially. But dividend cut still is not confirmed, and that's what estimates or analysts still pretend. I already said in videos before, we must be very, very prudent, careful in the current situation with estimates, because the broker doing, or analyst houses, or what do you call them, they are just overcharged with the current situation. Why? Because the economic situation declines so fast. We haven't, I can't remember we have seen something like that before, because of the anti-corona measures, which bring the economy to a halt. And for the broker also suffer from corona, so we also have to make home office. Some might even be ill, so they can't for each company update fast enough all these estimates. Technically, dividend stocks, cash, we are up to date, but the reality is that all estimates, it doesn't I pretend it doesn't matter which side you look on, or financial service you take, they will all be mostly unreliable. And this matters if you find attractive stocks like this, or such turnaround stocks. It matters a little bit less if you are interested in stocks like Amazon or such stocks, which are more or less, I can call them in one of the latest videos, with the eternal winner stocks. Okay, I hope this gave you an idea about the risk Carnival Investments face. I hope that you stay sound and safe, healthy, and that the crisis will pass soon. If you like, give me a thumb up, maybe even a comment, and I will continue to make some little videos like this one. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye bye.